แล้วที Digestive Endoscopy Center create FC Endoscopy Series for Endoscopy Education in YouTube our channel EndoEC channel. This is a FC ERCP Series. There are 10 topics to be presented. I would like to express our gratitude to Professor Nontri Pao Sawat, the President Thai Association for Gastrointestinal Endoscopy to support and endorse this program. And also thanks Boston Scientific Thailand to support as well. And I would like to personally thank Dr. Thanyaporn Chandaroseli, our colleague, to draw this beautiful medical illustration in this program. This program will focus on practical points to perform ERCP successfully and safely. FC ERCP series number one. Let's start with bile duct cannulation. ERCP cannulation, how to achieve difficult bile duct access from basic to advanced technique. I will start with equipment and accessory. Equipment, ERCP scope and system, fluoroscopy, serotonin sulfator, electrocycle unit. For accessory, synthetome, standard guide wire, FOPY, contrast. Something need to know before you start the procedure. Number one, major complication or even mortality can be happen. You need to inform benefit and list to the patient and avoid marginal indication. Number two, you need to balance between success and complication. Failure without complication is better than success with severe complication. Number three, be smart endoscopist. Professor already mentioned about the papillary structure is three-dimension image. But endoscopic image, you can see only two-dimension. Keep more one-dimension in your mind. For example, this normal ampulla. For the beginner, you can see this picture. But for explain, endoscopist can see the bile duct inside the ampulla. Number four, skillful assistant is important as well. And number five, you need to practice, practice, and practice, and self-audit to improve in your success. Basic scope manipulation and insertion. There are three positions for ERCP. Standard prone position. You can use left lateral position or even supine position. The patient endoscopy position different in all three positions. Anyway, left lateral position, the best position to is a scope from the stomach to the duodenal bowl. Knob control, big view up, the ampulla view closer. Big view down, the ampulla view far away. You see? And you big view up, the ampulla closer. Big view down, far away. Big view up is closer, and big view down, far away. For small knob control, if you rotate to the right, the skin will move to the left. If you rotate to the left, and the skin will to the right. You can see, if you move to the right, skin to the left. And if you move to the left, the skin to the right. This direction to adjust lateral direction. Ureter control, if you press ureter down, the catheter will going up. If you move ureter up, the catheter going down. And for sphincterotome control, if you bore sphincterotome, the tip sphincterotome will going up. So this other way to control the tip of the sphincterotome. Technique for scope insertion, after give good sedation, P-curve scope a little bit and put the scope in hypofiling. You keep it in 5 o'clock and insert slowly into the ureteral inlet without resistance and slowly put the scope to the esophagus just below each junction, roughly 45 cm, and then turn to the left at fundus area, suction to avoid aspiration. And then move scope
from the left to the right at 5 o'clock. You can see P-link and adjust P-link in the 6 o'clock and put scope down until you cannot see P-link, so-called sunset. The scope tip in the do not bow and slightly clockwise, you can see the way to the D2. When you say the way to the D2, you just light lock, clockwise pull back. You can see the ampulla and adjust the ampulla at the right upper quadrant for cannulation. This video clip to show P curve and then to the hypofiling. You can see retinoid. Keep retinoid at 5 o'clock. More easy than 7 o'clock. And slowly put in. Please remember, no resistance, slowly put in into the isovacut cut, you can see. Partly seen so cut. And then just insert below each junction. Slowly, slowly. And then close to each junction and turn to the left slightly and suction. This is the fundus area. And the way to the packling in 5 o'clock and put in slowly clockwise, slowly, slowly turn right. You can see this curvature, this packling. Keep packling 6 o'clock. Slowly put in until sunset. You can see the packling put in the do not bow. You can see the way to D2 in 5 o'clock. Very slowly, no resistance at all. This is D2. And right lock, clockwise pull back the scope tip into the D2 position. And then to identify the ampulla area. This major ampulla, normally in major ampulla is a D2 position. You can observe transverse fold and longitudinal fold this ampulla area. If you cannot find ampulla area, put scope down to inferior angle, sometimes locate in duodenal angle. If you cannot see pullback, to meticulous see this one, might be related with diverticulum. Even you cannot see pullback, some case located in the subpelvic area. So you need meticulous in and out to observe the ampulla. Just remind you, this major ampulla, this minor ampulla, this a relationship of two anatomy. In some patient, minor ampulla is more prominent. Sometimes you think about minor ampulla to be major ampulla. Adjust the ampulla location in aligned upper quadrant as picture in a good stable position. And then the direction of the CBD cannulation. The white one is the PD cannulation. Anatomy of ampulla and variation. There are many shapes of ampulla. You can see difference. This small dimple. This ampulla behind the flow. This quite typical ampulla. This ampulla in the dedenum fold. This ampulla related with diverticulum, interdiverticular, polydiverticular, and bidiverticular location. The shape of ampulla can give you the idea, the direction of the CBD cannulation, and also PD cannulation. Keep in mind the good location of ampulla to cannulation in light upper quadrant of the skin and take a look sometimes separate. You can see this separate CBD and PD. In case of pelvic structure that the ESP cannot put into the D2, you can use a balloon to dilate from 12 to 15 millimeter diameter of sea balloon, and you can dilate and put the scope through after dilatation. And one of the technique that we use when I delete the stricture and then pull back the half of the balloon inside, still keep half balloon outside at the tip of the scope and blow the balloon like a boogie, because this technique will keep the tip of scope is more taper, easily to pass through. Or some case that difficult and fail to the detection, also you can use hot excel 20 millimeter luminal diameter to dilate first, and then you can immediate insert pass through the D2 or wait for a few day later on and then come back to insert scope in. For malignant stricture, it's possible to paste, uncover, do not stain first, and dilate, and try to put scope in and cannulate the guide wire into the biduct, or you wait for a few days, keep the fully expand of the null stain, and then come back to try ESP and cannulate into the biduct. Cannulation technique. Right now, most of endoscopists prefer wide-guided cannulation technique, as pictured shown here. These four are CT studies to compare wide-guided first or contrast first. You can see success rate is no different in both techniques. But in terms of the post-endoscopic group of wide-guided cannulation less than group of the contrast study first. In conclusion, right now use wide-guided cannulation first and complementary for contrast injection if wide cannot go in. This group application of ESP cannulation review technique by Professor Martin Freeman recommend to see in this application. Once again, before cannulation, keep ampulla in the right upper quadrant of the image in good position. Biduct start the area of the left upper of the ampulla and more vertical in 11 o'clock direction. Preload the wire in the single tome. Keep the tip of single tome inside the opening of the ampulla. Adjust to the 11 o'clock direction and direction more vertical. And slowly insert the wire in, because you cannot see the direction of the CBD. The picture shown here, you can see the direction of the CBD can happen in multi direction. So endoscopist to keep the tip of the single tope inside, and nurse will adjust the direction in terms of the vertical and slowly put the wire in as picture shown here. And if the wire cannot go in, adjust the wire to change in terms of the change the direction or change the blowing of the single tome. You can see to change the direction and slowly insert the wire in. Sometimes you can see the adjust of the direction of the single tome maybe a little bit more blow to keep more vertical. And you can see this direction. Take your time to slowly insertion. You and your assistant will learn together how to succeed this biduct cannulation. In some particular case, you can see the direction not in terms of the straight, but like at the heel going up. So in this particular case, normally recommend to use more 4P wire, for example, Navipo wire or thermal wire. You can see when you put the tip of the catheter in and then up to the part of the heel, and then you exchange in terms of the pullback of the cattle more straight and correlation here. You can see picture shown here, put the Y in, and then you pull back the signal storm or pull back the scope to change direction, and then the nurse will more manipulate the Y inside. This we call Chu-Horn technique, manipulation the Y. If you encounter difficulty in terms of the Y manipulation inside the bi-duct, normally I use more 4PY, this is Navipo 025Y. You can manipulate the guide Y easily to go in. I will prescribe more detail in particular conduction technique related with shape of ampulla. Start conduction technique in ampulla related with the diverticulum. This inter-diverticulum type keeps scope close to ampulla or inside the diverticulum. Use suction or sometimes you can change to EG scope with cap. If the ampulla at the border of the diverticulum, same keep the scope close as much as possible, suction. And sometimes maybe use helper. For example, use two catheter technique or use rotatable synchrotome or use clip or clip with string or use saline injection technique. This is a technique that use the rotatable synchrotome. This you can use right now the true trome. You can rotate, you can see right now the opening inside the diverticulum. You put the scope close to the diverticulum and then rotate the tip of the synchrotome to the left and slowly to keep the tip of synchrotome close inside the opening of the diverticulum. Very slowly, very slowly. You can see. Keep the tip inside and then you rotate back, slowly rotate back, and then insert the Y in. This one of the technique to use rotatable synchrotome in this particular situation. Or you can use double catheter technique, but this technique you need to use only 5 frame double catheter technique. Or you can use liver sky wide echoing papilla. This in the literature you can use the hard part of the jack Y to put the mucosa close to ampulla and then keep push down to discover the ampulla opening, and then you can use the synchrotome to cannulate. This one of the crude technique. Or can you can use clip to grab the area close to ampulla and bring down to export the ampulla. But clip for the endoscope is sometimes very difficult. Recommend to change to endoscopic cap and more easily to keep. Or sometimes you can use clip visiting as well. Or some particular difficult in this particular case, you can see even clip, we cannot succeed cannulation. So this technique, we use the saline injection inside the diverticulum, a little bit far away from the opening, and this ballooning of the submucosal cushion will bring opening to export to the lateral and helpful for cannulation. Also, this particular case that difficult in case of the a lot of redundant flow. In this case, I recommend you pick up the needle knife and slowly to put the needle inside opening and then slowly cut. We shown you here. Put in and tip up to cut. put in the tip up to cut step by step until the opening to open and cannulate inside the bi-duct. Just remind you should avoid corneal cannulation in the same technique repeatedly because you take more time, more difficult and more risk in terms of the adverse event. You need to change one technique to another technique. Change direction, change catheter, change guide wire, or use contrast to help you to guide the direction of the bi-duct. Of course, sometimes very, very difficult. I will discuss cannulation technique when you facing difficult cannulation. This center publication recommend you to read in GIE 2017. This is the international consensus recommendation for difficult bi-duct access. You can see definition for difficulties of 10 minutes to cannulate or attempt 5 cannulation. So in this literature will guide you and give you the idea how to succeed in difficult cannulation technique. What should we do when you encounter the difficulty in terms of the cannulation? I divide two categories. The category one, you cannot put anything inside the opening. The category two, you insert the wire in the PD. Let me start when you insert the wire PD. The three techniques that you can use. The first technique, double wire guided cannulation. The number two, transpancreatic P-cut sphincterotomy or TPS. And number three, you put a stent in and you use double wire technique or you pick up the knife for the knife papillotomy or knife fistulotomy. Recommend the first technique with double wire guided because the technique compared with another two techniques is more easy. Anyway, more in terms of the post-SV pancreatitis compared with these two techniques. The TPS and NIN9 is a more challenging technique. You need to familiar these two techniques. Double guide Y cannulation technique, the first Y in the pancreatic duct, act as a landmark for the BD direction and mark strengthening of the common channel. And some particular case related with the diverticulum can fit in the good position. The technique you keep first Y in the PD and pilot the Y with sphincterotome and then bow sphincterotome to far away from the P direction and try to recanulate into the CBD. In some case you can use contrast inject to see the direction of the CBD. This pole position and supine position. This left lateral position and you paste the P-stent prior or later on. This chop with the keep of double wire technique. This is a conventional double wire technique. You can see the first wire in the PD and adjust the second wire in the CBD. In some particular case, the first wire encounter difficulty in terms of the cannulation. In that particular situation, recommend to put the PD stent first and then pick up sphincterotome prior the wire and recannulate. As same double wire guided technique. Let's put the PD stent first to make more convenient to adjust the direction of the bi-duct. The second technique is transpancreatic duct P-cut or septotomy, the first wire in the PD, but you rotate the cutting wire to the 10 to 11 o'clock. Like this, when you cut, you can open the loop and then you can see the bi-duct opening. This transpancreatic duct P-cutting or TPS. And some particular case when you encounter difficulty, you put the PD stent first. And then you pick up the DIN 9, this is the DIN 9 papillotomy and cut at the 10 to 11 o'clock, slowly cut. And then you can see by duct opening and create with wide and sphincterotome. This PD, this CPD. This small RCT study compared double wide technique with transperitoneal septotomy in 70 patients. You can see success rate the same, but in group of the TPS is less in terms of the post-ERCP pancreatitis. This is the study RCT compared with double wide technique and in 9, you can see the double wide technique is more easily and less in terms of the collection time. But the success rate is the same, and also a group of the double by look seem to be more post-ERCP pancreatitis. And this subsequent use double Y if fail chip to the transperitoneal septotomy compared with the DDNI, you can see it's more success and no difference in terms of the post-ERCP pancreatitis and less in terms of the collection time. So recommend to use the PD stent because when you put the PD stent in all this difficult technique can decrease post-ERCP pancreatitis. The second situation, you cannot put anything inside. You need P-cut or unloop. This is deny physiotomy, this deny papillotomy or P-cut with papillotome. This slide show deny papillotomy, you cut from the opening up to the close to the suprapapillary fold. You can cut upward direction or downward direction. This slide will show you the upward direction. You put the needle in the opening and slowly cut. And then to see the white tissue, this is a sphincter. And you slowly cut the sphincter. And you finally, you can see the bilateral. This is the knife physiotomy. This knife is to me, you cut not into the orifice, just 3 to 5 minutes far away from the ambulatory orifice. You can cut downward or upward, same as the knife papillotomy. Keep slowly cut, and not list the opening. And you can find this sphincter, the white tissue, and this the opening of the bile. Some study to compare with these two techniques, you can see in retrospective study, no difference in terms of the success rate. But from RCT study, you can see deny physiotomy less in terms of the post-ERCP pancreatitis compared with the deny papillotomy. The technique is P-cut with papillotome. You need to use a Lincoln tie, is no node. But if no node not available, recommend to use short node sphincterotome. You can see this just bending. You put the tip in the sphincterotome inside the common channel and rotate the cutting wire to the left at 10 to 11 o'clock, same as the transperitoneal duct P-cutting, and slowly cut, and then you can find the bile duct opening. This one of the other technique that you cannot put inside, use short node sphincterotome to cut same technique as transperitoneal septotomy. When you open the loop carefully to early gate to see the already cut area, you can see the clean one is common channel. And if you divide to quadrant, the most common bile duct opening in the left upper quadrant. You focus on the left upper quadrant first. If you cannot see, move to the left lower quadrant, mostly on the left side, some small percentage on the right side. Please remember, just take a look first, take your time, water to irrigate, make it clear view, not by cannulation. If you buy cannulation, you cross the breathing and more difficult to cannulate. And please remember, minimize post-ERCP pancreatitis. If the Y in the PD, always put the prophylactic PD stent in 5 cm. Or if rectal, NSAID or indomethacin is available, recommend to put before you start the procedure. And this is the roadmap for cannulation. Start with the singletome, pilot with wide first. If you succeed, if not succeed, you small injection or contrast to see the anatomy of the bile duct. If the wide in the PD, recommend to use the double wide first. If not succeed, chip to turn PD pre-cutting or pick up DNA depend on your experience. Remember, if you succeed in this difficult case, put the PD stent. And the final, if you cannot go in or difficult or fail the one Y or turn PD pre-cutting, put stent in and pick the ninth, start with the ninth physiotomy or ninth papillotomy. If you fail, maybe waiting for a week for the second attempt, or you chip to the US assisted or percutaneous approach. This is a roadmap for cannulation. Hopefully you enjoy this presentation and you can get some small thing to improve your practice. Thank you very much for your kind visit our channel. See you in next FC ERCP series.